My name is Philip Anthony Mitchell. I was born and raised in Queens, New York. I spent most of my time in the street, drug dealing and trafficking from a very early age. I even lost my freedom on more than one occasion. I'm involved in a lot of illegal activity. By the age of 18, come to a point where I can no longer stay in that city. I began to feel very suicidal and very empty. I even remember one night laying in my room with a bottle of alcohol in one hand and a shotgun in the other. And just trying to get myself to the place where I could actually pull that trigger. I wanted to just end my life. I had no real sense of direction, no real sense of purpose, and no real sense of hope. In those days, leading up to November of 2003, I knew that I was searching for something, but I wasn't exactly sure what it was. It was around that time that I had crawled into a bathroom on my knees and surrendered my life to Jesus in the small bathroom of an apartment. And it was in April, some time later, that God spoke to me for the very first time about the plan and purposes he had for my life. He had spoken to me about a church that my wife and I was to start. We did not know how, we did not know where that church would be. And I wrote down everything God showed me, and I tucked that paper away in an old picture frame that I still have to this day. It was June 2010 when my wife and I had just graduated Bible college. We took what little money we had at the time, got a rental truck, and packed up our family and all of our things. We arrived in Atlanta. We didn't know anyone. We had no jobs. We had no money. We just came here by faith, believing God. This was the city he had told us to come to, and this is the place that work was going to be started. I remember in the beginning, we would often drive around the city of Atlanta. We would see the people. We would walk the malls and go through the stores. The very first time we did that, my wife, she began to cry, and I looked at her and I began to weep just at the things that we seen happening all around us. Immediately, a burden began to settle on our hearts for the people of this city, for Atlanta as a whole. They knew that we were definitely in the right place. And the time had come for us to start the work.
You feel what I'm saying? Like, he was just walking around and stuff, screaming he finna start a youth church.
Our work in Atlanta began with a youth ministry called The Vibe that Lena and I started at a local church. There were 20 teenagers at the church at that time. We had set out 40 chairs, believing that everybody would bring at least one friend. When we opened doors, 104 students had showed up that night. The church began to grow from that point forward. Students started coming by the tens, by the 50s, by the hundreds. We started seeing testimonies of life change. We started seeing teenagers confessing their sins and giving their life to Jesus. One night, we had baptized 78 students. 28 of them had come forward spontaneously.
My daughter has always been faithful to church because we were faithful. She had to come. But once he came, there was a hunger and a disappointment when she couldn't go. I remember one time specifically, Cynthia actually cried because she couldn't go to church. Like, you crying over church? But that was the impact that he had on them.
I came from the gutter, like the slums. I ain't never had nothing. I grew up around D-boys. But like, from my experience with the Vibe, Pastor Phil himself, without him, I'd probably be dead by now. He saved my life.
In that year, we had reached over 1,000 teenagers. It was at the ending of that year, at the height of the ministry, God began to speak to me. The time had come to now step out and begin the work he had spoken to me about 8 years prior. And so my wife and I, with 10 other believers, stepped out on faith to begin the groundwork to plant Victory Church. And our first meeting was held in a hotel in February 2012.
And although we was not officially a church yet, although we had no physical location, working off our own contributions, we immediately went out to the street, into the community. We began to minister to the homeless and those who were less fortunate than us. We began to share the message of Jesus. We strongly believe that Victory Church will be a beacon of light in the Atlanta area. We strongly believe that Victory Church will be a place of hope. It will be a place of restoration. It will be a place of healing. It will be a place where Jesus is lifted up, where the word of God is taught with clarity. We believe that Victory Church will be a place where people will find a second chance. Help us make Victory Church a reality. I'm calling on every open heart that feels the cry of our hearts to sacrifice with us to open the doors of Victory Church by going to victorychurchatl.org and click on the link that says giving. And even if you are unable to give, help us get the message of this video out by sharing it with as many people as possible. help us lead people from defeat to victory.